Everybody, welcome back to Hand of Fate 2. It's finally time to try Judgment again. And I've given it some thought. Not a lot, but some. So first of all, let's remove all cards. We're gonna be building a new deck. Get out of here. Get rid of you. Okay. We have three platinums to pick from. So we're gonna put in that.
I guess that card is one of your favorites. I don't see the appeal.
Right, that's gonna be our platinum. Then, what do we get from this? Blessings, money, and one platinum equipment. So we want more equipment, which means we are going to get, you guessed it, Thomas the Ogre out. Put that one in too, of course. Put in temple prayers too. Blessings can only be good for us, right? Thomas the Ogre. And we got 13 more. I'll try to stay away. So let's put in return to Rumstock. We do get 15 fame at the start of this, if I recall correctly. So that's gonna make sure that is a success. Helpful priest can help. Friendly innkeeper. Alright, let's put in some food ones. Let's use our filter for that. Resources. Food. I'll put in that one, that one. Okay, some gold. Cartographer could be good because a lot of the encounters already are revealed to start. Did I put in caravan robbery? Probably did. Let's see. No, I have not. Not yet, at least. Okay, let's put that one in. It's a good one. Okay, what else? I'm gonna put this one in because I have an idea for my artifacts. Put in a mystery chest? Nah. Soothsayer. That one. Let's put this one in, you never know. Okay. Now for my equipment. My idea is to get one of every available one. I can just put in like one weapon, one thing, and you know, guarantee myself to get that one. So I think I'm just gonna put in a bunch of shields because I don't really care, but for the artifacts I will be going with Lion's Heart. It should guarantee me getting that one. For armor I'll probably pick something that makes my job easier on gambits. Let's go with Imperial Armor. For my helmet, probably pick you. For a ring, I'll pick you. So this should mean I start with that, 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 and that. I could still do the same thing for my weapon. Or a shield, admittedly. I think I'll put in the exquisite blade, or was no, not the exquisite, that no, brilliant blade. We need 16 fame, that shouldn't be too difficult, so let's put that one in. And then we just have to hope that we have 17 shields. Let's see. We don't. Okay, I guess we'll put in some more weapons then. Let's put in Winter's Bane. Law and Order. Rethazire. Cardinal Blade, and that one. Now for equipment, knowing that we start off with one of each, I will keep the fine sword, but I'll chuck leather armor and instead take extra gold, and I will also start with healing spirits. For equipment, let's check out one of the shields, and I'm going to take the ring for better dice gambits too, I think. Are there any more here? Let's put that one in two. Okay. Well, let's see if this crazy plan of mine works. Okay.
Now the die has been cast, and we see how the escape will fare.
Alright, so it's too easy, so it says, yeah, okay, we know this. Blood, whoa! Why am I down to 70 health? Should all companions escape alive? We'll go with Malaclips to join us. Sanguine Blow, perform a powerful attack, deals 150 damage. Blood Pack, lose 50% max life when you equip this item. I guess we're gonna keep this equipped then. We did get Lionheart, didn't get Grifter's Companion. We'll start with the Ram Shield. Bash causes damage to armor. All right. Fingers crossed, I guess. I should also have the... whatever. Let's go. Okay, we immediately start off with a good one. Food, gold, and I get our 20 health back too. One, two, three, four, five. It's 25 gold, 10 food, and 20 life. That's not bad. Well, assuming we don't lose any life. Let's make our way back. That is fine. We still got 20 health. Raccoon's another 5 because we want. Where would be the most difficult to get through? We'll go this way first. And then we'll double back again. Let's go this way. There we go. Alright, easy does it. Must be one hell of a sword. It does 22 damage, which is pretty much at the level of a hammer. Let's hope it fares us well. Minus half of your HP, that is pretty bad. Fosters up into the immersion of the forest, the morning sun burns your eyes. Okay, let's try to retreat. Can we do that safely? Yeah, we can. The wounded peasant stone chase power corrupted. Let's fight. And we'll get to see Super Malaclips. Which, the only difference being that if my shield gets broken, surrounding enemies get damaged. But hey, it's something, right? Look at that! He often commented as brushes with death go was most convenient. He needed a new spellbook anyway. Malaclips' protective barrier will now explode and impact, damaging enemies around it. That did a good amount of damage. Malaclips is down, let's bring him up. Going for the red guys first because I shouldn't have used that. Because I know the red guys only have green attacks. I know the other ones only have red ones, but this should make it easier for me to. Riposte. Gotta love it when you get hit during animation. Okay. I wonder why we did so much damage. 102. Is that dependent on our life or something? Wait for your protection.
I'm not a vain man. You must appreciate that the game, this game, has been my focus for more years than I can count. I have a certain pride regarding its twists and turns.
All right, a bunch of food. Let's see. There's a brilliant blade. It's not really what I'm here for, though. I actually just wanted to check my inventory. Perform a powerful attack that deals 150 damage. Oh, it just deals 150, period. Okay. Where are you going, man? Yes. Thoroughly impressed with the knowledge he has gained. I thought that card would be a good one. We put ourselves in a bad spot again. Okay, two blessings. Be blessed for luck. Be blessed for good health. Okay, cool. Find a capacity and cover an alley across here, we know. Gerald knows a way. You know what? Considering I've got a bit of a fickle start, let's see what happens if we really have to fight all of these. You give the nod and your companions ready their weapons. Var. Looks in the eye, no, we're not going to get through unscathed, but I see another way. Each available companion will attempt to remove a monster card. No. Cool. So I dash towards a group of any sort drawn.
The pendulum is ever changing, and the challenges it presents change too.
Cool.
That will set you in good stead from here.
Marcus blows. Blows. Wow. Need to say, I'm about to say glows. Ah. I won't redraw. We need him in combat.
Move faster next time.
Oh. Well, had I known that, Mighty Warcron charges first enemies.
Back to the bones. I hope you have learned to be their master. A win here sets the tone for your challenge.
Let's get rid of the Juggernaut. Ain't that bad. Deal draws a life pay card for every monster in card until 4 remain. That's a lot better. If you go through the canyon, you still have to fight 3, I think. And we lose 2 equipment pieces. We have healing at hand, so as long as I don't forget to use that. I'm without a companion, though, which is unfortunate. Blood Crescent. For centuries, this weapon has been in the hands of brutal warriors, happy to give their own life to fuel it. Now it's yours. Yeah. I wonder if I could get them all to come to heal. And I get some free pot shots in on the spire. Well, yes and no. Still no reason to drink. Shots on the spire. If I can do that one more time, he's gone. The spire's out. Okay, I'll use my super on one of these chumps. It'd go to waste otherwise, anyway. Okay, now I can take him out. That hit during animation, I really don't like that, but... what can you do? Go. Okay. Off you go. You're next. Alright, come on. I'm surprised I dodged that one. And off we go. Alright, so it took damage, but... we kept our equipment. Which is nice. So much health too. Here are shouts, soldiers coming down the street to learn about commotion, mark up shouts, we must get to out of the city. Yeah, sure, that's a word now. Okay, well, we may as well keep Malaclips around to get him back up and on his feet. We'll fight. It's more corrupted. We are in a bad spot, mostly because our current weapon is bad against corrupted. And by bad, I mean still better than base equipment, but it's not tailored to fight corrupted because we get actually 30% less damage. Which puts it probably at the same thing as a normal sword. Some shields are beautiful, some are functional. This one is inspired and powerful. Dodge there, but failed miserably. Time for a sip. And you might be thinking, well, why would you? You can probably heal by just consuming food, and you're not wrong. But I also have exploding doodads and... So I might as well try to gain the health bonus and then regain my uses of this artifact. Or even more health and healing during combat. You know, you gotta keep in mind that usually the only way to lose is to drop to zero health. So as long as we have like a whole plethora of healing items available, we can be in a really good spot. I think I might actually take another sip. Cool.
That should help.
All right, so I think I'm pretty good as far as food goes. Nice. All right, break camp. Okay, ambush. That is quick, isn't it? You got it, though. We got Terror of Blight and then something else. Close, but we got it. Are we gonna remove another one?
Timed.
Leaving us just with the Terror of Blight. Shouldn't be a problem. There's a few of them. Terror, those are the red guys, right? Or are they the big ones? Which are also red ones, but... Yeah, they're big ones, okay. The big red ones. In any case, I'll be glad not having to fight Corrupted anymore. Berserker of Frost. I'm doing this one mostly to get my companion back. Five turns ain't nothing. We'll finally get to see... how our weapon holds up against something that... you don't have a debuff against. Someone attacking me? Try again later. All right, moving forever onwards. Another whole buttload of food. That's always nice. All right, time to go. We missed out on a raider's ambush. Am I gonna go back for that? No, because you can lose food. City limits. Bells continue to toll as a crowd of paupers and townsfolk fill a square leading out of the Imperial City. Hey, Malcolm's back. Guards block the way, checking all wagons and persons trying to enter and leave. People cry out and protest, let us through, let us through. They are only met with a wall of shields blocking the gates. Stella beckons you, Malaclips from the alley across the street. You press the crowd, avoiding the guards, and join your companions. There are more soldiers here than we can ever hope to defeat, Stella whispers, and they will only gain in numbers the longer we linger. Somebody must be sacrificed, Colburn mumbles. Malaclips laughs, his scornful hat bells jangling. Not have to be so cheery about it, although we don't send me because I won't be enough of a distraction. Ariadne's blue eyes looks reverently between the two. Surely there's no way we can all escape. No, Colburn is right, it is the only way, Stella says. Turn to the group. Someone will have to draw the guards' attention for the others to escape. At a special time, who will it be?
Well, we have to fight Empire... Thieves... This is an Empire thing, so maybe you are the one to send out?
We know it's not Colburn. Malcolm's pretty much said, don't pick me. And we know Ariadne is used on the next one. So yeah, let's try you. Sora waits for you all to get to the front of the crowd near the gate. Then, like a martyr to the gallows, she steps onto a merchant's cart. Soldier of the Empire, her voice rings clear and commanding. The square falls silent, save for the ringing of the bells in the distance. I am Estrella Fiore, former captain of the Empire and the Emperor's assassin. After shock pause, the guards spring into action, shoving past the fence to get to Estrella. With no fear in her eyes, she glances to you, Malaclips, Ariadne, and Colburn, nodding in acceptance. Suddenly there's a shout from one of the peasants, it's the savior of Farwater! She saved the town from an army with naught but four people on her side, Nera calls out. The peasant king, he said she would return to lead us to freedom! Like a great machine whirring into action, the peasants turn as one and charge towards the city gates. Silence this rabble, capture the conspirator, a captain cries out, before he is knocked out cold by a traitor's soup pot. Seeing her opportunity, Stella slips into the crowd and rejoins you and your companions as the soldiers scramble to fend off the riding crowd. Without stopping to look back, you flee the city and head to northeast towards the marshes.
Sick!
Save your Farwater, eh? Malaclips quips as you flee into the swamps. Stella smiles. We got lucky, and we can't hope to survive on luck alone. She turns to Ariadne. You know these parts, where do we go from here? Ravenna looks over the marshland. West of here is a bridge across the river, and beyond that is the way to the mountains. Flee the marshland. Malcolm stares at the fire, and beyond the mountains is the marigold fields and the caravan. Alright. We'll fight our way across the bridge too, I guess. Sure. Three food, that's nothing. 15 gold. Minus 5 gold. More food. More gold. Less food. More food. Less food. Sure. Let's see. 55 and 83. What happens? I'll skip through these because it's not that. 55 and 83. Keep that in mind. 55, 83. 55, 83. 55, 83. We lost 3 food and gained 15 gold. That's exact the same as you'd pay for that on camp. Speaking of camp, what's for sale? The Brilliant Blade. I'm gonna stick with what I have, honestly.
Alright, time to fight a buttload of bandits. Right, Pants, take cover a short way from the bridge across the raging river. As you approach Colbjorn and emerge from the undergrowth, there are many armed men up ahead. They bear not the banners of the Empire. Bounty hunters are at the mutters. I'm sure the Empire has put a handsome price on our heads. The guild could not resist such a reward. I'd like not to lose companions here, but, you know, I'm still gonna try and fight. Success. Okay, let's get the assassin out of here. Need a 13. Nice. And now for Malaclipse's shindig. Let's get... the silencers out of here. Oh, and Malaclipse doesn't get his turn. That's good, that's good. I tended to screw that up anyway. It's true. You know it. I know it. And we got rid of the most annoying ones, anyway. If nothing else, I'll get a party. Oh, Malaclipse, you didn't stay up long, did you? And my super isn't actually ready yet. Oh, it is. Malaclipse is having a hard time keeping on his feet, eh? I mean, that's not bad. As long as I got my shield up, I don't really... I'm not gonna say I don't care, he's still doing damage, but... we know it doesn't do much damage, you know? So it's nice for him to be around, if I have my shield up. I don't care all too much. Keep in mind, I still have my, artifact, which I really should be using. And Malaclipse is gone, okay. Now let's go get our shield back. Yeah, Malaclipse is having a hard time staying up. We're getting through him though. Only a few left. At least you weren't brimstone. Cool. Alright. Another barrier crossed. With no equipment lost. It's all weapons which I don't want. This one's new, so let's see what it does. No.
Now you can reap the rewards of your justice.
Can I go back, or does that mean I have to fight this again? I kind of want to go see what's up with these. Visit the Gold Mountain. Money. Food. Bad. Do you really want to buy more food? Let's see how much he asks for that. If he only asks for 10, then by all means. Tja. I guess we're gonna have to fight the Empire now. Oh, you can just keep on doing this. Nothing personal. Well, it's less people than last time, but we do have that silencer in there. We may want to try and focus him down. Wait, it's a silencer. It's not like the boss, is it? Oh, it is. Okay, we'll try to focus him down then. Okay, the big wild card is out. I still don't like how you can just jump up halfway across the map, but... Why is there a hat on the floor? They make such weird noises. Ow! Hey! Can't say I saw anybody take damage in that. I suppose now would be the good time to get the exploding doodads. Not gonna lie, it would be useful. We'll switch out to our other artifact, which still gives us 30 health in combat if you need it. And we do have second winds. Healing up as well, but you know, we do have to be careful here. Can't avoid your fate forever. One man gasps as he falls. Sure. With a bit of luck, we can switch out when you have to fight Empire. The next green monster. We'll go for Frost. Said, I hope I'm at least.
Your artifact is empty now and will be of little use.
Right, this has changed that. I hope that doesn't get me killed. That would be a shame. As long as I don't go after the brimstone guys, we shouldn't be expecting red attacks from them. Come on, this shouldn't be difficult. Leave my buddy alone, right? Ah, lucky you. Oh, that's bad. Block there. Then again, I've thought that so many times, and I'm pretty sure I'm right on a few of those occasions. Improper timing, I guess. Because clearly nothing can be wrong with the game. In any case, in case you are wondering where the butts I'm going to the end to use Fate's Path. Every third repost against an ordinary deals 200 damage. Nah. We'll go. Let's cook food. What was the equipment again? The brooch. Brooch shield ain't bad. We can use that for a final bit. Camp. Move on to our healing spirits. So yeah, I'm looking for Wanderer's Bounty. Shields of Plenty. Exploding doodads, are you in here? No, but I will go for Caravan Robbery. Temple Prayers, and probably Thomas the Ogre. Unless we don't have an option to do that. Fire companions huddle around a small fire at the beginning of the foothills at the edge of the marsh. Together, yeah. Who should distract the thieves? Our magician. Right? We found them alongside a thief, so yeah. I'll give some time Malcolm draws her sword? Okay. What happened? Before you even think to do anything for Malcolm Stroud, guys, buddy. Well, I guess we won't get gold. And Malcolm's is gone. Fleet Hinterlands. Well, let's see what we get. We'll take Colburn with us. Break camp. And let's start moving. Sure, it's a lot of food, but... Effect of all gain chance cards apply twice to elite level, then discard this card. Alright. Mm. That's a bit sad. So it's not dependent on what faction you go against. Well, now we know. I might aim for gold. Off camera. I really should not have hit you. And I wasn't planning on, but, you know, the game decided that, hey, you probably want to fight this big guy with your regular attack, which does nothing, right? Oh. Here's what I don't know. Is there another map after this? Ow. Why would you die? Well, it was different, because the first time, it definitely was the ogre thing. As long as I don't lose life, I'm alright with it. Ah, I still have one of your artifacts refilled. Lionheart. Lionheart uses have been recharged. Sick. No. We'll hold it until the other one is empty. We'll probably have to fight because there's nowhere to go. Yeah.
Did you not consider that the Empire would stop at nothing to ensure you are found?
Kinda did, but you didn't leave me with much choice. Then again, I may have put myself in this corner, so... You know. Oh yeah, I have a shield. Him. Dude, did anybody told you that you got like way too much armor? Why won't you just straight up die? And we just lost second wind. Well, that's a shame. But the big guy's dead. Could you like stop attacking me, all of you? Can I stop getting hit during animations? Oh. Okay.
Ow.
You can get hit whilst doing an attack. You can get hit while simply having a sip of your drink. Try to explain that.
Yep. Second wind is gone.
Raider's ambush. There's Elder's gift. Raider's ambush. Friendly innkeeper.
Same thing.
And we'll fight.
I think that's the other bad one. Let's get rid of Tyrant.
No. Yes.
What an unfortunate time for your skills to leave you.
At least these aren't doubled.
Alright, so standard procedure, go for the shaman.
We'll probably have to switch to Estrella to try and get her back on her feet.
Yep.
Alright, let's carry on.
Phone call.
Alright. Let's try to go for Shaman, who is there. Otherwise known as completely surrounded. And I made the horrible mistake of not equipping my artifact. That might be a small problem.
Well, Shaman's dead.
Let's go get our buddy up.
Try to take care of as many people as we can.
Which ideally would be all of them.
You know, I kind of do like the weapon. I'm kind of wondering how well I would have done had I not lost 50 health. Well, I would have 175 health at this point, wouldn't I? So.
Well, I might have been dead by not having a good enough weapon.
Who knows?
There's still a pool of dudes left.
Yeah.
Well, that's one way to take care of a lot of them.
All Wow, and there's still a bunch left.
We might be at the end of our journey, though. At least getting close to it.
I just broke through the main barricade, so to speak. No. No.
Last known as Fiedicte, your escape through the canyon to the pass in the west.
That's double two. Dude, we just got like two, so much life back.
But we're not gonna be stupid. We are going to equip Lion's Heart for another easy 150 health.
So we're bound to lose another companion based off of
me needing Malaclips at some point. I'm no longer having him, meaning we have to sacrifice another companion. Stop moving. Dude, that was a double hit. What? And I blocked one of them, so that was a clear indication that I was pretty much just screwed back there. You guys shall not impede my movement.
Oh, butts. Thought I could beat him.
Thought I could roll out of the way of that one too. Shows you what I know.
Look at that curve on that boa. Look at that. Defying the laws of physics.
Unless one of those balls is heavier than the other one, but I don't know. Maybe. Nice one, Colbjorn.
Pitiful bash, I will admit.
He doesn't care about his stun either, it seems.
There we go.
Alright, do you want to go and grab what I assume to be Grifter's companion? It's either that or... try not to lose food, not that we can. There you go. Another 20 food and a bunch of life. You know, things are doubled, so.
Nice.
Reaper's companion. Are you gonna draw another one?
No.
That would have been a bit too much, wouldn't it? What do we have on our left? Waterfall of Youth, which is another set of free food. I don't think it matters what we get here, but we may as well aim for success, right? It's good practice. Both full-grown adults. Beginning of each new app, draw one life gain card. Another 14 food. Now, which is this? Friendly innkeeper. May as well have a look. It's the last place to stock up on food, I would imagine. Buy food.
Doesn't look like it's working here. Let's buy a bunch of food regardless. That's enough for now. Leave. We'll go buy the food from camp. Might work there. Trade. What's the equipment? Shield. No, I don't want that. 6 food for 15. Okay. Break camp. Yeah, another 50 life too. Well, we're gonna lose that soon. Alright.
This card is not lightly called Judgment.
Join.
Here you must pay the price for your regicide. And also for your decisions.
You join your companions at the foot of the Paz's plan. As you begin your ascent, more than a wanderer emerges from the craggy rocks and block your path. This is going to be a Colburn thing, isn't it? Clan Crowfoot, Colburn growls. They who burn my village and my people to ash. Rockver's successor is smaller, much younger, and ordinary steps forward as you approach. Colburn of Clan Eyebright, he calls. You best us in battle, and as right, we bear no qualms with you, but you cannot bring the Empire here. Turn back. There's only one way forward to the Marigold Fields into the caravan. There are directions only spelled death. You must send someone to parley with Clan Crowfoot. Corbin approaches Clan Crowfoot. They bow to him, and he in turn bows. They talk quietly to one another. In a tense moment, you fear it will turn to blows, but Rogvir's successor merely clasps Corbin by the neck. Rogvir was right to fear your return, he shouts. The Emperor is dead. It is as the High Priestess desired. We claim Crowfoot's honor to hold the pass while you and your comrades make your escape. Together you make your way over the pass while the Northerners move back to hiding to wait for your pursuers. You send a mountain pass and enter a forest dotted with blooms of red flowers. The Marigold Field, Colburn points in the caravan. Sure enough, in a clearing you spy a lone wooden caravan. Mournful horn signals the Empire is closer than ever. You set off at a run. Much here. More food. No longer doubled. But, I mean, come on. We have plenty of food. Not a red one? Nope, return to Rumstock. Give me gold.
You have made bitter enemies, and the best of them will stop you now. One step closer, and you will reach my threshold.
Fools, he calls. No one can hope to escape the Empire's reach. You've survived this far, not by luck or skill. You've survived because we let you. He chuckles. If the sacrifice of an Emperor is what it takes to draw out the last of the mages, then it is a price that must be paid. Knight steps aside as soldiers completely surround you. No. Actually, this is probably the end, so we might as well try. Huge success. I'll probably be using Colburn for the combat anyway. Let's get the captain out. So the dash towards a group of enemies sort of drawn. Ugh.
Breathe, you have done well.
And out they go. So be it, the knight says, stepping forward. He lowers his helmet and drawing his weapons. He calls the last of his men, charge. Or something along those lines. Anyway, we've got a ton of health. Let's just say it as it is, right? We got lots and lots of health. At front lines of great upheaval, there are always men who flounder anywhere but in the midst of battle. Heavily armored knight can easily turn the tide of battle, use bash to break their armor. This guy does not have any armor. And I got shot in the face! Okay, that's gonna be the annoying horn out of here, at least. Now you... Actually, let's get Coldborn up and... Keep an eye on my health, don't worry. Ooh, that hit him through the armor. There's a cooldown on that bottle, so I might as well use it. Get out of here. No, double attack. There goes him. Okay, let's get Coldborn on his feet. Such a weird scream. That phalanx boy. Come on. All right, fine, we'll go for him. No problem, huh? Rush in. Oh, you're not ready yet. Okay. Should be good to go now, right? Even through a stun, you managed to be annoying. Commendable. But annoying regardless. And off you go. Cool. Justice done. Hopefully, well, more through good deck building and a little bit of luck on the gambits, but yeah, we have to fight like all of them.
Here we are, perched at the moment of revelation. One more must fall.
You stumble across a clearing, the caravan waiting ahead of you. Four mages lay lifeless on the ground. Among them is the familiar gaunt figure of the hermit. Relinquished of the fabric mountain that draped him in the winter forest, he lies in a simple pale robe like a burial smock. More soldiers will soon be upon you, familiar disembodied voice echoes in your head. You must draw them away from the caravan before all is lost. We're not done yet, huh? I'll try to hold on to Coldborn for as long as I can. No fear, Narya on his face always knew I'd die a hero. Before he can protest with a roar, she rushes into the Empire's direction. I'm
Mercy, familiar goblin standing by the caravan. He beckons you over, opening the caravan door. You make the final dash across the field. Exhausted, you open the door and a voice calls to you. Come, sit, catch your breath. It will not follow you here. Your memories are fading even now. As we set the piece in place, gone to form the soul of the game we play. No Goldie, but oh well.
And so the circle is complete. The entire journey to my door has been unwoven, and we understand how we came to be. Now there is only one.
We're in the caravan of Marigold's Fates. We get the Feast of Kalas 1. Oh great, it's gonna be one that goes on forever and ever. Adventurer's Aid and Shadow of the Empire.
It has been timeless, our journey together. But now we see the truth of it all laid bare. You must help me. And together, we will return this world to the way it should be.
Well, I think that is going to be it for this episode. I will do some off-camera farming to get the other 3 gold tokens. I'll be sure to record what I get from them. I might do some questing for some normal tokens. Which I will also record when I do get them. But for now, thank you guys for watching. Hope you're still new in the series. Feel free to support by coming, liking, or sending me a fan already. And I'll be seeing you guys on the next and potentially final episode. Bye, everyone.